It's fine. You don't have to worry.
Wait, what happened to the green button?
We are alive.
Hi. Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So we're in my mom's living room because the internet went bad on Vena campus because they're doing construction and because Allah is testing our, you know, our will to continue educating. Yeah. So we're going to, the intention was that this was supposed to be a dream student session. We're doing review of, you know, some grammar that we've been learning since, was it October?
Yeah, October.
Yeah, so late since October. Then. So we're doing some application of grammar, which is obviously not for everybody. If you guys haven't been studying Arabic from the beginning, that's not for you. But the other part of what I was going to do with them in Ramadan was I was going to go over a really beautiful book that's in Arabic. It's called Al-Tabir al-Qur'ani by Dr. Fadel, Saleh, Al-Samerai. It's a physical copy of the book, Al-Tabir al-Qur'ani. And I was going to start giving them examples about, you know, from this book. And instead of explaining what this book is, I thought I'd just read them the introduction and kind of translate it line by line. It's a long introduction. So I'll probably do session one today, maybe 10, 15 minutes. And then probably do another one tomorrow until we finish reading the introduction to the book. And then we'll just take some really cool examples from it and take it from there. And inshallah, in the meantime, our internet connection gets solved on campus. And I don't have to stress out my parents with invading their living room, inshallah. Okay, so let's begin. And I'm just going to start reading.
I have it.
Yeah, so At-Ta'bir al-Qur'ani, Qur'anic expression. So the Qur'an's way of the style of Qur'an speech. That's what the title of the book is. لا خلاف بين أهل العلم أن التعبير القرآني تعبير فريد في علوه. In fact, let me share my screen so you guys can see the book too. Those of you that would like to follow along.
I've already shared it.
Oh, you are sharing it? Okay.
Yeah, I
stopped having it. لا خلاف بين أهل العلم أن التعبير القرآني تعبير فريد في علوه وسموه. There's no disagreement between people who truly have knowledge that Quran style of expression is unique in how exalted. Exalted means how high quality and how high standard it is. وَأَنَّهُ أَعْلَى كَلَامٍ وَأَرْفَعِهِ And it's the highest form of speech. وَأَنَّهُ بَهَرَ الْعَرَبِ And it bewildered the Arabs. They didn't know what to do with it. They hadn't heard anything like it. فَلَمْ يَسْتَطِيعُ مُدَانَاتِهِ وَالْإِتْيَانَ بِهِ بِمِثْلِهِ And they weren't able to come up with something that can compete with it or to bring something that's similar to it. مَعَ أَنَّهُ تَحَدَّاهُمْ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ مَرَّةٍ Even though it challenged them more than one time. Mm-hmm. So Allah basically said, okay, well, if it's not from God, then you should just be able to do it. Do it. Make your own Quran. لَقَدْ تَحَدَّ الْقُرْآنُ الْعَرَبَ ثُمَّ جَمِيعَ الْخَلْقِ So the Quran challenged the Arabs, then it challenged all of creation. بأن يأتوا بمثله to produce something like it. ثم أخبر أنهم لن يأتوا بمثله and then it informed them that they are not going to be doing something like that. They're never going to be coming up with something like it. ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا even if they were to support each other and do a collaborative project to come up with something like that. فقد تحداهم أولا بأن يأتوا بعشر سور مثله so it challenged them first and foremost to produce at least 10 surahs like it. وَإِنْ كَانُوا يَرَوْنَ أَنَّهُ مُفْتَرَى If in fact they think or they see that it is made up, meaning made up by a person. فَقَالْ So Allah said, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ This is in Surah Hud, and this is Ayahs 12 and 13 and 14. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ Are they then saying that he made it up? قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ Then tell them to produce 10 surahs like it. مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ made up also. وَدْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ And call whoever you can other than Allah, if in fact you're telling the truth. فَإِن لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكُمْ And if they haven't been able to respond to you, فَاعْلَمُوا Then all of you should know. أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ That it has been sent down by Allah's knowledge. وَأَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ And that no one is to be worshipped in any way, shape or form except He. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ So are you all going to accept Islam? Are you going to surrender or not? فَلَمَّا انْقَطَعُوا وَقَامَتِ الْحُجَّةُ عَلَيْهِمْ And when they were stopped dead in their tracks and the case was made against them, what this قَامَتِ الْحُجَّةُ in Arabic, case was made against them means that they were told, hey, so if I'm wrong, prove me wrong. And they couldn't do it, which means they lost the case. And the way that said is the case was made against them. or the case was established against them. That means you definitely lost the case. You got stumped. تحداهم, it challenged them again. بأن يأتوا بسورة من مثله. That at least it challenged them again to produce at least one surah like it, something like it. وأخبر أنهم لم يفعلوا. And he also told them while challenging them that they're not going to be able to do so. فانقطعوا أيضا. And they were stopped dead in their tracks again. وقامت الحجة عليهم. And the case was made against them another time. قال تعالى, Allah said, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ. And if you have been in any doubt, مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَى عَبْدِنَا. Or if you've been in any doubt over what we sent down onto our slave, فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ. Then produce a single surah, anything like it. وَدْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ. And call your witnesses, your experts, مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Any besides Allah, إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If in fact you're telling the truth. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا. And if you're not able to do so, and if you haven't done so, وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا. And you won't be doing so. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ. Then protect yourselves from the fire. الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةِ. The fire whose fueled by, or whose fuel is people and stones, basically lava. Right? Mm-hmm. If a fire is being fed by stones, that means it's turning into lava, right? وَعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. It has been prepared for those who disbelieve and deny. وَأَكَّدَ التَّحَدِّي بِقَوْلِهِ. And he then reinforced that challenge with another statement. And what's that statement? قُلْ لَئِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. Tell them, even if the humanity and all the jinns, the human species and the jinn species, all of them got together for the one purpose of producing the likes of this Qur'an, لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ. They will not be producing anything even close to it, anything like it. وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Even if they were to be reinforcing or supporting each other. دَعَ الْقُرْآنُ الْعَرَبَ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ. Now the author is continuing. That was, by the way, Surah Al-Isra, Surah 17, ayah 88, to be quoted. دَعَ الْقُرْآنُ الْعَرَبَ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ. The Quran invited the Arabs to produce a surah like it. وَيَشْمَلُ هَذَا التَّحَدِّي قِصَارَ السُّورَ. And this challenge included the shortest surahs, كَمَا يَشْمَلُ طِوَالَهَا. And just like it included the long surahs. فَهُوَ تَحَدَّاهُمْ بِسُورَةِ الْكَوْثَرِ والإخلاص والمعوذتين والنصر والإلاف قريش أو آية أو آية سورة يختارونها أو أية سورة sorry يختارونها. So he said he challenged them with سورة الكوثر. إن أعطينا الكوثر just so short. Or make something like سورة الإخلاص. Or you know قل أعوذ برب الفلق إن أعوذ برب الناس. Or إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح. Or لإلاف قريش. These are short surahs, right?
Yes.
So he's like, well, okay, you can't come up with بقرة. That's too much of a project for you. 50 pages. Why don't you just, you know, just Surah Al-Kawthar? Or any surah that they can choose. وَمِنَ الْمَعْلُومَ أَنَّ الْعَرَبُ لَمْ يُحَاوِلُوا أَنْ يَفْعَلُوا ذَاكَ. And it's already known that the Arabs who didn't believe, they didn't even try to do it. فَقَدْ كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ عِجْزَهُمْ عَنْهُ. Because they already knew their inability to do so. وَرَأَوْا أَنَّ السَّبِيلَ الْحَرْبُ وَالدِّمَاءُ وَالتَّجْمِيعَ الْأَحْزَابُ أَيْسَرُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ مُقَابَلَةِ تَحَدِّ الْقُرْآنِ. This is amazing. He says, and they knew, they saw that the path to take up war with the Prophet, mm-hmm. to spill blood, their own also, and to gather all the tribes against Islam was easier for them than just making a surah. Like, look at what they did to stop Islam. Allah says, you want to stop Islam? Just make a surah. Mm-hmm. And just say, look, it's as beautiful as this one. It has the same effect. It transforms people the same way. What's the big deal? Anybody can do this. You could just do that. You didn't have to go to war. You didn't have to spend millions. You didn't have to lose lives. You didn't have to, you know, create that, all that, those sacrifices. Because it's not just Muslims who sacrificed. The Quraysh also sacrificed, right? Mm-hmm. But Allah says, you didn't have to. You could just prove Quran wrong. Mm-hmm. And then you didn't have to make the sacrifices. وَمِنَ الثَّابِتْ أَنَّ الْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ كَانَ يَأْخُذُهُمْ بِرَوْعَةٍ بَيَانِيَّةٍ. And it's established, it's proven that the Quran just took a hold of them with an awe. بِرَوْعَةِ بَيَانِهِ, sorry, بِرَوْعَةِ بَيَانِهِ, with the awe that it grabbed, the attention that it grabbed with the way that it talks. وَأَنَّهُمْ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ عَنْ سَمَاعِهِ. And they couldn't even control, the people who didn't believe in it, they couldn't even control themselves from listening to it. وَلِذَلِكَ سَعَوْا إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَحُولُوا بَيْنَ الْقُرْآنِ وَأَسْمَاعِ النَّاسِ. And that's why their campaign to stop Islam was to get between themselves and between the Quran and the ears of people, meaning how can we get people to not hear the Quran, mm-hmm. because it has too much influence, وسعوا إلى أن يصل إلى الأذن, and they tried that they tried hard that it won't reach ears. لأنهم يعلمون أن مجرد وصوله إلى السمع يحدث في النفس دويا هائلا وهزة عنيفة. Because they knew that just listening to it, just somebody's ears getting the Quran in it, is gonna cause an echo that shakes them from within. And it's gonna cause a tremor that's very powerful, a forceful tremor, hizzatan anifa. وَقَدْ حَكَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ هَذَا الْأُسْلُوبِ. And Allah then described this campaign that they, this strategy that they adopted to stop Islam. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, this is in Quran Surah Fussilat, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَأَلْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. And those who disbelieved said, don't listen to this Quran and make a lot of useless noise around it so that you can win. In other words, now this is really important, the enemy of Islam realized in the time of the Prophet that these people, if they hear, if our people actually hear the Quran, it's going to transform them. So our biggest campaign is to keep people's ears busy with something other than the Quran, so they won't pay attention to how powerful it is. If you think about that, that's a really incredible thing to internalize. That means the most powerful force for the transformation of a human being is the word of Allah, and even the enemy realized it. And that's why they actually put a lot of money in Mecca into the concert and music industry when the Quran came down, so that there would be lots more on the street concerts and noise going on. Because back in the day, obviously, nobody's on their mobile device getting entertained, right?
Yeah.
So you got to go outside to get entertained. Mm-hmm. So outside, people were hearing Quran and it was influencing them. So they wanted the media waves to be flooded with entertainment so that people wouldn't have the attention to listen to the Quran. Now realize what that implies for us and for the Quran. Like, we are accepting Quraysh's strategy for not letting the Quran influence us by, they don't have to pay for musicians and, you know, for entertainers to keep our ears flooded so we don't pay attention. We're doing that for them. We're paying the musicians now. We're paying them to keep ourselves entertained and stay away from Quran. So Quraysh would have had a much easier time in our times.
Yeah.
So like, oh, these people, these are the people of Quran. You don't even have to distract them. They're distracting themselves. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. We don't have to worry, because even they're going to be so drowned and like zombied by entertainment that even when they come to the Quran, they're going to be like, oh, I don't get it. Right? You guys understanding this so far?
Yeah.
Just a little bit more. وَكَانَ صَنَادِيدُ قُرَيْشٍ وَأَعْتَاهُمْ مُحَارَبَةً لِلرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَأَشَدُّهُمْ كَيْدًا لَهُ وَنَيْلًا مِنْهُ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ عَنْ صَمَاعِهِ. And the leaders of the Quraysh, and the most arrogant among them, the most defiant among them, the ones who went out of their way to be at war with the Messenger, and the ones who made the worst kind of schemes to try to get to him, they couldn't help themselves from listening to the Quran. فَقَدْ كَانَ كُلُّ مِنْ أَبِي جَهْلٍ وَأَبِي سُفْيَانَ وَلَخْنَصُ بْنُ شُرَيْقٍ يَأْخُذُ نَفْسَهُ خِلْسَةً لِسَمَاعِهِ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَالرَّسُولُ فِي بَيْتِهِ لَا يَعْلَمُ بِمَكَانِهِمْ. So Abu Jahl, each one of these people, these were three of the millionaire and like political like
leaders,
like mayor, governor types, mm-hmm. right? Was Abu Jahl, Abu Sufyan, who was a Muslim at the time, and Akhnas ibn Shuraiq. There's three people, Abu Jahl, Abu Sufyan, Akhnas, right? They used to grab themselves slyly, like leave the home secretly, to listen to the Quran in the middle of the night while the Prophet ﷺ was reciting the Quran in his home, like praying tahajjud. Mm-hmm. And the Prophet doesn't know that they are where they are. So they're outside his wall, kind of putting their ear to the wall, mm-hmm. listening to the Prophet recite the Quran. Because in the daytime, they said, don't listen to this. But the nighttime, like, I really want to listen. It's so good, though. And so they'd go and they'd listen to the Quran, right? وَلَا يَعْلَمُ أَحَدٌ مِّنْهُمْ بِمَكَانِ صَاحِبِهِ. And none of them knows that the other one is on the other wall. So they came from their home on their own, and they're all listening to the Quran, and they don't know that the other guy's on the other side listening too, right? حَتَّى إِذَا طَلَعَ الْفَجْرُ تَفَرَّقُوا. Until morning time came, now they're going to get spotted, right? Fajr came, so they dispersed, they left. حتى إذا جمعتهم الطريق تلاوموا. Until the road they're going to exit from is the same road. So they run into each other as they're sneaking out of the Prophet's, you know, outside of his walls. So they start blaming each other. What are you doing here? What are you doing here? قال بعضهم لبعض, they said to each other, لا تعودوا, listen, don't come back. فلو رآكم بعض سفهائكم لأوقعتم في نفسه شيئا. They said, if some of the fools around, meaning the young people, mm-hmm. and the common people, they call them fools, right? Because they're the elite, they're the millionaires. Yeah. So they call the public fools. Yeah. If some of these fools see you, then you'll have put something in each of their souls. Like, mm-hmm. they're like, oh, they're listening, we should listen too. ثُمَّنْ صَرَفُوا. So they left. حَتَّى إِذَا كَانَتِ اللَّيْلَةُ الثَّانِيَةُ. Until the next night came, the second night. عَادَ كُلُّ رَجُلٍ مِّنْهُمْ إِلَى مَجْلِسِهِ. Each one of them returned back to his own spot in the, outside the house of the Prophet to listen. فَبَاتُوا يَسْتَمِعُونَ لَهُ. So they spent the entire night listening to him. حَتَّى إِذَا طَلَعَ الْفَجْرَ. Until Fajr came. تَفَرَّقُوا وَجَمَعَتْهُمُ الطَّرِيقُ. And then morning time came, they don't want to get caught, and they're heading back, and the road, they caught each other again. فَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ. They said to each other, مِثْلَ مَا قَالَ أَوَّلُ مَرَّةٍ ثُمَّ انْصَرَفُوا. So they said the same thing. Don't come back. We told you. Okay, yeah, got it. We're not coming back. And then they left. حَتَّى إِذَا كَانَتِ لَيْلَةُ الثَّالِثَةِ. Until the third night came. أَخَذَ كُلُّ رَجُلٍ مَجْلِسَهُ فَبَاتُوا يَسْتَمِعُونَ لَهُ حَتَّى إِذَا طَلَعَ الْفَجْرُ تَفَرَّقُوا فَجَمَعَتْهُمُ الطَّرِيقُ فَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ. Oh my God, they called each other the third night in a row. Same exact thing. So they're like, yo, this isn't working. Because you know politicians lie, right? So they're like, yeah, I ain't coming back. He's like, yeah, I ain't coming back. And they turn around and say, yeah, right, I ain't coming back. Shoot. You stay home, I'm coming. So they called each other three nights in a row. So they finally said, لا نبرح حتى نتعاهد لا نعود فتعاهدوا على ذلك ثم تفرقوا. So they said, we are going to continue doing this. We all, listen, let's be real. Okay, nobody's here, so we can just be real. You know we're going to keep doing this until we make an oath. We need to take an oath that we will not come back. And so they took an oath on each other because the oaths were a big deal back then. And then they parted ways. فَقَدْ أَخْبَرَ اللَّهُ نَبِيَّهُ بِهَذَا الْأَمْرِ. So Allah told the Prophet what was going on, because the Prophet had no idea what's happening, right? نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ إِذْ يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِذْ هُمْ نَجْوَى إِذْ يَقُولُ الظَّالِمُونَ إِن تَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا رَجُلًا مَسْحُورًا. We know better what they listen to carefully, when they listen to you, and when they have their secret meeting, when wrongdoers finally come out and say, oh, no, they come out to the public and say, you're just following someone who's been enchanted. You're following someone who's a victim of magic. وَمَا قَوْلُ الْوَلِيدِ بْنُ مُغِيرَ بِسِرْ. And what Walid ibn Mughira said secretly. This is the last thing I'll share with you. فَقَدْ اجْتَمَعَ إِلَيْهِ نَفَرٌ مِّنْ قُرَيْشٍ. So a group from Quraysh gathered to, Walid ibn Mughira was there, like, he was like their, you know, Fox commentator. And he was really well-spoken, very aggressive, and like, anybody who's going to come on his show is going to get humiliated, right? So nobody talks over him. He talks over everybody, right? So, and he's very well spoken, so and intimidating. So they said, we should get him to shut Muhammad down, because we can't shut Quran down, but this guy, man, he's a pit bull. He's going to go after him. Mm-hmm. He's going to wreck him. So a group of them came to him. لِيُجْمِعُوا عَلَى رَأْيِ الْوَاحِدِ يَصْدُرُونَ عَنْهُ. So they came to him and they said, we need to come up with one campaign slogan that we will distribute to the masses. يَقُولُونَهُ لِلنَّاسِ فِي الْمَوْسِمِ. Especially because a festival is coming when all the people are going to get together. We need to have a campaign where we all say the same thing. Because what happened was, some people were calling the Prophet, oh, he's borrowing from the Christians and the Jews. Some people were saying he's a liar. Some people were saying he's a magician. Some people were saying he's insane. Some people were saying he's a mind reader. So all of these are contradictions, right? Because he can't be a magician and a genius and insane and, you know, and getting it from the jinn and, you know, and a Christian and a Jew at the same time. It doesn't work, right? So when they kept making different kinds of accusations, those accusations started canceling each other out. Because people were like, these people are just desperate to try to say something about him because they're not saying the same thing. So they said, we need to have one accusation. We stick with it and we all say the same thing. and it sticks on him. So, and especially because a huge gathering is coming, we need to have that blanket campaign so that, because if everybody says it, it'll feel like it's the truth, mm-hmm. right? That's how propaganda works. If enough people are saying the same thing, then you feel like that's what the truth is, right? Mm-hmm. So some of them suggested, maybe we should just say he's a good poet. Another one said, he's just a mind reader. And others said, no, we should call him a magician. And another one said, no, we should call him insane. فَكَانَ يُرَدُّ هَذِهِ الْأَقْوَالِ كَانَ يُرَدُّ هَذِهِ الْأَقْوالِ وَيُفَنِّدُهَا. So he would, meaning, Walid ibn Mughira is the head guy, right? Mm-hmm. He's like, he's the one that's going to broadcast it. Mm-hmm. He's like, no, that doesn't work. Oh, that's dumb. That's a dumb idea. Don't call him one of these. But why? Because he had heard the Prophet, mm-hmm. right? So this is what he said to them. Some of them became Muslim later and they told us he said this. Mm-hmm. إِنَّ وَاللَّهِ I swear to God, إِنَّ لِقَوْلِهِ حَلَاوَةً I swear to God, there's no doubt about it, his speech has a sweetness in it. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْهِ لَطَلَاوَةً And it's overrun with beauty. وَإِنَّهُ لَيَعْلُوا وَمَا يُعْلَى عَلَيْهِ And it only overpowers, it is never overpowered. That's what he did with Mughira. In his private meeting, what to say about the Qur'an. So he ends this passage by saying, إِنَّ التَّعْبِيرَ الْقُرْآنِ فَنِّيٌ تَعْبِيرٌ فَنِّيٌ مَقْصُودٌ Qur'anic expression is an expression that is artistic and purposeful. كُلُّ لَفْضَةٍ بَلْ كُلُّ حَرْفٍ فِيهِ وُضِعَ وَضْعًا فَنِّيًّا مَقْصُودًا Every word in it, all the wording in it, in fact, every harf in it, every letter in it, has been put in a place that's very artistic, beautiful, and purposeful. So there's two things that Ta'bir al-Qur'ani, this is a really nice way of summarizing his book. He's saying the way Allah speaks is always beautiful and purposeful. Two things at the same time. So speech is both beautiful and purposeful. The thing is, when you're in a class, the teacher can speak purposefully, but it gets boring,
yeah.
right? Mm-hmm. So it's purposeful, but not beautiful. Mm-hmm. Or you could enjoy poetry or a song or music or whatever, and it's really beautiful in some way, but it's definitely not what? Purposeful.
Yeah.
So the Quran is beautiful and purposeful at the same time. Fanni and maqsood. The style is fanni and maqsood. وَلَمْ تُرَاعَ فِي هَذَا الْوَضْعِ الْآيَةُ وَحْدَهَا وَلَسُّورَةُ وَحْدَهَا بَلْ رُوعِيَ فِي هَذَا الْوَضْعِ التَّعْبِيرُ الْقُرْآنِيُّ كُلُّهُ So he's saying that this wasn't taken into consideration. It wasn't just a single ayah alone that was made beautiful and purposeful, or a single surah that was made beautiful and purposeful. But this was the Qur'an itself, the entire Qur'anic expression was made in this style, meaning the whole thing was, Allah took into consideration making it purposeful and beautiful all throughout. So that's the premise of his book. And then he's going to go on. And he's quoted some things like Sayyidat ibn Hisham. These are some of his sources. But inshallah, I'll read some more of this to you guys tomorrow because it's a long introduction and some fun things. But yeah, wanted to do a little geek out with you guys.
It's a nice introduction.
Right?
I hope she like you want to know more.
Yeah. He's very interesting. And the book itself is just really unique. It's very interesting work. So inshallah, we'll look at some of his examples in class. And even though this wasn't the public broadcasting, this was actually meant just for my students. But I figure some of you might enjoy at least, you know, getting a taste of why it's important to study Arabic too for the purpose of connecting better to the Quran. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum, guys. Remember, do your best and I will do the rest. Love you guys. Happy Ramadan.
Yeah, Ramadan.
Ramadan.
Okay.